Hey everybody, welcome back to Northern Lion Plays the Binding of Isaac Rebirth. Oh no, who were we on the last run? I think we were Eve. No, we were Samson, so that means we got Azazel now. I remember now. I was thinking I had nightmares last night about that Eve run where I freaking killed myself in the curse room right off the bat in a way that makes me a little salty. Bad trip pill in the curse room. God dang it. 2-8-D-8-8-V-7-9. Nice eights, mate. Nice meme, Northern Lion. We're the meme police. You cracked a joke that has been cracked before. I'm sorry, that's 30 years hard labor. Alright, hard labor. Well, let's be honest, what I do is probably not necessarily hard labor. Labor, yes, a labor of love, though. In any case, we're Azazel. Last time we played as Azazel, we ended up doing like a pseudo speed run that I almost like completely botched towards the end of it. I think it's because we picked up Brimstone. I was so excited about it, but then I threw it, but we won. So I'm probably gonna play it, you know, to play like 10% slower. That might give us extra damage, I'm not sure actually. To play like 10% slower is probably a smart idea, so I don't end up having like the most frustrating Azazel runs of all time. I think that might be a sound idea. In any case, I'm always happy. Ooh, in our character rotation whenever Azazel pops up, because Azazel is probably the most consistent character that it's easiest to win with. For me. Other people might feel differently. I know some people feel that, you know, maybe Isaac is a little easier to win with because of the D6 erasing, or having a good chance to erase negative items from your item pool. For me, it's Azazel, man. The extra damage, the ability to fly to start with. Where is my bomb to access that? I don't really care because we already have a pretty good setup for getting deals with the devil in the future. This room is unfortunate, let's just put it that way. But let's take care of the jumping spiders first. And then the other spiders will quickly follow. I wonder if we can get them all. Nah. I was thinking we could get them to break and then get them killed at the same time. But unfortunately that is not possible, you know? You always crack a Kit Kat before you... Ooh, that's really good. You always crack a Kit Kat before you eat it. Okay, this is actually incredible. You know, just shove the whole Kit Kat into your mouth. Where, you know, you gotta break it up first. My thinking here is that it's awesome that we're fighting famine. If we get a... We should go down so that we... Jeez, be careful there. Yeah, we should go down so that we can attack him perpendicularly. If we get a cube of meat, we have a small chance of actually getting Meat Boy on this run. I was just complaining about it on Twitter, because that's where I do all of my hard-hitting investigative journalism. And, you know, oh, I didn't get the cube of meat on my last run, whoop whoop. But this does mean that we have about 3 more floors in which to hopefully find a Book of Revelations. We have the cube of meat precedent. With the cube of meat precedent, we will exclusively get cubes of meat from horsemen bosses, you know, the harbingers of the apocalypse, if I fight them. There's always a chance, I think, for Headless Horseman. There's always a chance for Mr. Fred, well, not always, but on the womb. There's always a chance for Conquest, but if we get all the horsemen, this should give me cube of meat. Or they should give me cubes of meat, I should say. And we actually are in a unique situation here where we have 2 key rooms, which means one of those could easily be a library. In fact, should be a library. Hopefully, we can just get some goddamn keys. Now, the good news is with 10 cents, well, we have 9 right now, but presumably with 10 cents in the future, we should be able to, if we open up the wrong room, still make it to the point where we can buy a key and then open up the right room and hopefully get a cube of meat in the process. Whipworm. I mean, it doesn't really matter. Not a cube of meat, sorry. Book of Revelations. Pheromones. Hoping for bombs or key or something. I swear to God, if we get no keys, I'm going to be so mad. One key at least gives us a chance. No keys is just the kiss of death. So we did get the one key there. Second? No, but 2 bombs, which actually means that we should be able to bomb our way into one of these rooms now. There's not that many possible locations here, and there's another key, thank God. Okay, could the dream be a reality? This is our shop, where we can't buy a key, so I guess that we're pretty lucky, actually, that we managed to bomb our way in here. Although we had 2 keys, now that I think about it. So, oh, we got one from the secret room, though. Oh, it's just the Bible! I'll take 2 of diamonds right away. I mean, we might as well take 2 of clubs right away because I'm going to hold on to the fool card. How could you, game? You give me a library and then it's just a freaking biblio. Ugh. Maybe we'll get... Well, even if we get a Purrthro rune, I can't drop my spacebar item. So we're just stuck holding this for now. You know what? Remote Detonator is better. It's not the end of the world, though. You know, we might want to pick up, like, Piggy Bank or something. Oh, you know what? Steam Sale's on the cheap. We'll pick up Steam Sale. And then Piggy Bank, which is already half price, but... Now we have Steam Sale for future floors, so we only need 7 cents in order to make our dream a reality there. However, we're not sunk yet. We could still be fine if we just find a library on a future floor, or even just a random Book of Revelations inside of a an item room. It is in the item room pool. It could happen. That was a bit of a frustrating library there, but that's okay, shit happens. If we could find it on this next floor, I'd be much happier about the situation, but, you know, we'll find out, I guess. We want to keep the Fool card. I actually like Lucky Rock a lot, so I should not have taken that pill. I was thinking, oh yeah, we're going to take 2 of spades, that's it. So we'll get up to 4 keys, take the Fool with us, and then our deal with the Devil, Ceremonial Robes, will actually gain more HP than we lose, and that's pretty excellent from an HP standpoint. Awesome. So money's not going to be an issue right now as long as we have bombs. What we really, really need is to find libraries, but this is it's a great setup so far. For a win, this shouldn't be too bad. Man. Like, we're already put up in a pretty good position to have a great chance of winning. The issue with this run is whether or not we'll be able to do the overarching goal, which is more important than a win right now, and let's just get a freaking 4th level cube of meat, or even a 3rd level cube of meat to make me feel a little bit better about myself. Because I have, in like 260 hours or something of Rebirth now, I still have not even had a close call when it comes to Meat Boy. Hello, Kate.
I got Benji's Girl, level 3, twice.
Yeah?
I got Meat Boy, level 4, twice.
That sucks. At that point, the first, like, level 3 Bandage Girl after you got those Meat Boys, I would have been like, okay, we're pretty close. The second one, I would have been like, fuck.
Super Meat Boy, twice.
Lucky you. That was before they patched it, though, Kate.
Yes, it was harder.
No, they made it harder in the patch.
No, they didn't.
They did. They made it so you can't cheese it with Sharp Plug and Monster Manuel anymore.
Yeah, well, I didn't use that, though.
Yeah, but you could have. That's the point. That's the point.
No, I could have gotten Meat Boy and Bandage Girl at the same time due to the patch. But I didn't. I got the Meat Boy, Super Meat Boy.
It's just luck. You don't have to brag about it. You're just lucky. You know, if you win the lottery, you don't brag about winning the lottery.
I do.
You gotta give me some of those winnings then. Legally, I think. Probably.
Maybe.
Here's how you use Remote Detonator, Kate, because I saw you having some issues with it. You gotta put a bomb down, and then you just hit the space bar, and, you know, you win forever.
I thought you were gonna use it.
No, those enemies are you crazy? You want me to fight those guys? I have pyro, so I don't care that I'm wasting some bombs here. Ah!
I thought that's how you use it.
You're very funny. Hey, check it out. That's how you use it right there. Get out of here. I was having a good dialogue with my viewers. You're distracting me. Just trying to brag about getting your cubes of meatses and all that. Well, we should not... With pyro, I mean, the pyro pickup's great. We shouldn't have any problems getting extra money. And the pills are coming fast and furious. If only we had luck upgrades, maybe we could have a better chance of getting something from them. I don't know if that's exactly how, like, the special rock works. If you have a higher luck stat, you have a better chance of getting a luck up or getting a drop from it, but I'm going to assume that that's how it works. Oh my god, we're the luckiest people in the world. We're fighting Pestilence randomly on our second floor, which makes me feel good because I could have easily fucked it up by not exploring more. Like, if I had done some more exploration, we might have had a chance to actually find our Book of Revelations. So that was really stupid of me to just go fight the boss like that, but it ended up sort of working out. Much to my surprise. This could be the dream right now. This never happens. Both pheromones, just making sure. This is our shop. I mean, we have so much money already. We might as well buy a PhD. We might as well pick up this. That's a bad gas pill. Balls of steel. It's lovely. Sure, why don't we get broken stopwatch? Doesn't really matter which one we take with us. We'll try to donate a little bit on this run. Now we have more pills back there that we can actually make good use of. Probably. In the meantime, I'm gonna take a quick look around. I don't think we can find, like, Book of Revelations in our secret room. There's a speed upgrade. But I may look in our secret rooms anyway, because we can. Well, if I'm gonna look for a secret room here, I gotta put it down, like, there. I forgot that we have a remote detonator. I guess our secret room is probably going to be here, then. Alright. I'm not proud of that damage. I don't really care about that money. Money's gonna be easy to come by for us, hopefully. Then I guess our secret room must be here. It is indeed. Wait, I need to take the Fool card with me. Where did I drop that? Like, 2 rooms ago. That's fine. The Fool card's important for the chance to get the other thing that we need for real Platinum God, which is, the D100. Another speed upgrade never hurt anybody. Bad gas. It has hurt many people. Probably. Non-fatally. So we have 2 cubes of meat. It would be extremely nice to find a library on this floor and pick up Book of Revelations. I would, basically, I just never want to have to worry about finding a library on the first floor again. I never want to be like, oh, we're not finding a library, like, GG. Not that we would say GG to that. That's a little bit reductive, unnecessarily. I'm just saying, you know, I want to be off the roller coaster. I want to be driving a car instead of being on the roller coaster. What is wrong with me? Did you see that damage? That's why I should use remote detonator more often, is because I need to get used to it. My rate of fire is a little bit worse than I anticipated for some reason. I don't buy the hitbox on those guys, but we got enough HP that it doesn't really matter that much. Making good time when it comes to the boss rush room, of course. Alright, please be a library. We found it early that... Oh, it's a double key room. I don't know if that can contain books. It can contain a decent amount of money. Was that worth 2 keys? I'm not totally sure about that one, to be honest with you. Pheromones, relatively meaningless. It's a decent pill, but I don't like carrying it around. Or I don't care about carrying it around, I should say. Alright, please God. Now, you know, the other thing that a second level cube of meat this early does is that it makes me have a little bit more of a time, like, leniency. Careful. For when I can actually get Book of Revelations. Like, I can get it as late as the 5th floor now, and still have a good chance of getting that 3rd level, and then 4th level, cube of meat afterwards. I'm excited, though. I think this is the closest we've ever... Oh, Jesus. Oh, it's because Small Rock is busted up here. Or not Small Rock, sorry. Broken Stopwatch is messed up here. I was like, these guys are real fast. They're so fast, they've actually broken the segments between the Larry Juniors. There we go. I'm very glad that that room is finished now. Come on. Book of Revelations. Book of Revelations. I never want to have to worry about this Meat Boy ever again. By the way, for people who are like, you know, you could use Sharp Plug, Monster Manuel, like I was saying to Kate, that's been patched out. The only thing I could do that I think would make it a little faster, but would also be very tedious, is just, you know, do what most people do for the Lost and just hold R all the time and hope to get a Book of Revelations in your first item room, or use Eden tokens and hope to start with a Cube of Meat and Book of Revelations, or, you know, one or the other at least, and then do it that way. But that sounds very tedious to me. You know, I don't play Isaac to get the achievements. I play Isaac to play the game. I'm hoping that it'll just happen naturally and we won't have to worry about it. I'm gonna keep exploring first, which it doesn't really make any sense to do, but I'm gonna do anyway. It's not like we're gonna... Even if we found a Book of Revelations, it's not like it would give us another level of cube of meat, but figured it was worth a shot anyway. I don't know why I'm taking such damage, just being very sloppy, but Balls of Steel's helping me out a great deal. Just money, and that's another Balls of Steel pill, I think. Ghost Baby, which means at least we won't find Ghost Baby in our Angel Room. We've slowed down a little bit here. Our Devil Room, sorry. Why would I go with Angel Room, of all things, in that context there? Another Balls of Steel. Yeah, I've been slowing down more than I should be. We still have 87 bombs, though. We can speed things up pretty quickly, and all we need to do is get to the room. We don't necessarily need to make anything happen in that boss rush room, especially within like a specific time set. We can just leave. You know what? Sorry about that. I appreciate it though. We definitely want to go to our shop one way or the other, even if it is greed. Because we have, no reason not to, basically. We don't really want the ladder. A luck upgrade is perfect, though. I love that. Then we'll leave. We'll donate some if we have the time. And I'm thinking we probably will have the time. Man, if only somehow I could fight Pestilence again. And then not have to worry too much about running into no Book of Revelations. Which is still, like, the most likely outcome by far. Is just not getting a Book of Revelations. But we could just get insanely lucky and fight war on the next floor. Maybe, like... The game saw me tweeting and is like, I see you tweeting about me, motherfucker. I'm not unfair with this achievement. I'll show you how unfair I am by acquiescing to your demands. Please do. Little Steven. I think we will take... I mean, I don't think Headless Baby is particularly good. But we'll take it. And you know what? Remote Detonator's been fine, but... Let's take Pandora's box. And if I can save that for the cathedral, we can snag like a free angel item, or I could use it on Utero 1 or 2. Either way is fine. So we got about 3.5 minutes per floor. I am not taking Isaac's heart. I apologize for it, but I'm not gonna do it. Don't need to blow these up as much anymore. But I will blow them up anyway. What is hitting this stuff out of the way? It's like little Steven is pushing my freaking bombs out of the way. Don't do that. Or maybe it's Ghost Baby. I'll blame Ghost Baby because I like little Steven. Might not be fair, but that's the way I'm gonna do it. It's one of the very rare situations we have where it's actually like totally fine for us just to mess with Pandora's box like this. Normally, don't get the opportunity to do so. Because you usually have a better spacebar item. Again, the money not that important unless we get, like, an unprecedented amount of donations. If you're wondering, by the way, why did we have a different colored balls of steel there? Bad trip becomes balls of steel, even though the logical conclusion for most people would be to assume that it would become full health, because that's what it becomes anyway. Yeah, it's actually becomes balls of steel, strangely enough. Which is actually more universally useful, so I appreciate it, but it takes a little getting used to. So one of those must have been a bad trip. See, there are some times when Bad Trip would actually be better than Balls of Steel, but, you know, that's neither here nor there right now. You know what is here and there and everywhere is my dream of becoming the cube of Meat Overlord. I'm not going to fight the boss just yet, because if we fight the boss, really it's just like we're rolling a dice and it's like a 1 in 20 chance that we end up fighting war and getting a cube of meat as a result. If we can get Book of Revelations through one of these rooms somehow, and it's a low chance by exploring, but we gotta maximize our chances because we rarely find ourselves in this position and never want to find ourselves in this position again. Okay, so you got a little Gish. Maybe that removes the Gish boss, or maybe it makes it so maybe Gish can drop a cube of meat. Let's be honest, that's unlikely. These ghost baby bombs are messing me up, dog. It's alright. I like Lucky Rock more than the Birdfoot. That is not a library, unfortunately. Bombs are key. Nah. We'll just keep buying keys. Okay, and we'll throw one away immediately. You gotta throw one key away. It's like in poker, you know, in Texas Hold'em. You don't just, like, flip over the next card in the deck. You gotta burn a couple. Like, that was gonna be a bad key for us anyway, so we decided to burn it. It's a ceremonial thing. You gotta turn them and burn them. That's the standard key protocol. Don't even question it. Turn him and burn him. See? There you go. See, what it's like a forest fire. What's burned is now renewed. Not that all forest fires are good. Well, it's looking like we're not going to find a library. So really, it's just hope against hope at this point. Well. I know that I'm shooting these. I know that's my fault. But it's still regoddamn-diculous. We gotta go faster if we're gonna get the boss rush, man. But I have to go to this other room just in case somehow there's a library off of it. There's not. And I took one full spirit art of damage against spiders, but it was in the interest of going fast. So, let's do it. I'm ready. Oh, the sneeze. I'm not ready. The sneeze is real. What did I tell you? Gross. Nah, it's not war. So I think we have now lost our chance of getting 4th level Meat Boy. Have I told you lately how much I love this achievement to become Meat Boy? I think it's really balanced and I'm very glad to have it. I think it makes the game better. I love Rebirth. That doesn't mean I can't say anything negative about it. I think Super Meat Boy being required for Platinum God is kind of silly. But that's, you know, a lot of people think a loss being required for Platinum God is kind of silly. It's all about your playstyle and stuff like that, I guess. A lot of people have Cube of Meat. Most people get Cube of Meat. Well, most people get Cube of Meat before they get the Lost achievements anyway. But that was also before it got freaking patched. A lot of people end up cheesing the game to get it. Now, if there's anything wrong with that, I'm not above that right now. I hate this room with Slow. We got 17 and a half. We should still be able to get the boss rush. And, okay, now we can start just talking about whether we think this run is a one run or not. We're Azazel, so it's looking pretty good. Admittedly, we haven't really improved our damage very much over the course of this run. Our HP has been good. The Pandora's box pickup, who knows what that might give us in the whole scheme of things as well. But if this is a library, I'm going to be pissed. It's not a library. I'll take Sharp Plug, why not? I'm not going to bother... That's Balls of Steel, though. I'm not going to bother with Magic Fingers. We did use it recently on a run with Brimstone, and it was a lot of fun, but... Pandora's box, I think, is a little cooler for us. There we go. We got a basically HP upgrade there, which I don't really want, actually. Now that I think about it, hopefully we'll have the opportunity to trade it away. But yeah, we're in a good position from a winning perspective. It could get a little touch and go. I mean, I've been taking some bad damage over the course of this run, but PhD has provided us with a steady stream of Balls of Steel pills to compensate for the fact that I've been playing like an asshole. A little bummed about the whole Cube of Meat thing, but hey, it's nice to have an orbital. We do get a deal with the devil. We got plenty of time, so we'll take the Polaroid just in case we luck into like a Cube of Meat somehow. Pentagram on the cheap is a good thing, and... The Forget-Me-Now is not actually useful for us here. As much as it might... This is the worst selection of items I've ever seen. I don't even want to pick up anything so it doesn't show up again. I just want to walk out. That's how I'm embarrassed. Now, we could Fool Card out and explore the rest of the floor. I'm going to do that because I wanted to do it anyway, but... Isaac's Tears, Blood Rites, Forget Me Now, Crack the Sky. Has there ever been a worse boss rush than that? That is a damn good question. Double Key Room contains some red chests with some Spirit Hearts. Already making me pretty glad that I explored the rest of the floor. One of these, I was going to say, is Balls of Steel. I think at this point we can get rid of Lucky Rock. Our money situation's good. We get a speed upgrade. One of the reasons I came back is so I can start filling up this donation machine again. You know, I've got a backlog, and I left a backlog in the toilet this morning. Seriously, though, it was brutal. But, oh, how did that happen? Anyway, nothing has pained me more than hearing, like, getting messages from people. And they're seeking me out on all sources now, but... Getting messages from people that are like, Northern Lion, your ignorance of the donation machine is making me feel real bad. What you should do is just blow it up so you don't accidentally give it some money. And then, of course, you know, in my head, I'm like, wow, you have no idea how right you are, because semi-recently, I just completely fucked it up. But I don't really care about having a bank that's open all the time, you know? Like, I'd rather just play the runs dynamically as if the bank wasn't there, which is totally like a me thing. Like, it's a Rebirth mechanic. The people who take advantage of the bank are probably gonna do better on average than the people who don't, but at the same time, come on, bro. How much extra money do you need? The game is already kind to you on a regular basis. And if it's not, hey, take it as a learning experience, you know? I don't know. No, it's on me. I've got to learn to, let go of my, like, vanilla foibles. But yeah, it was a stupid mistake, but hopefully a Northern Lion-esque stupid mistake. It's like 10 videos ago now, so... Hopefully, you know, the blood is dry and the wound is healing. We got 16 keys already out of, Flat Penny, which is pretty excellent. Our damage is now a lot better as a result of... the pentagram pickup. Okay, okay. Sure, I don't mind a speed upgrade. Who doesn't like a speed upgrade? It can't be there. I'm not even gonna let it go off, because I'm mad at myself. It can't be there either. You know why? Because it's gated by that room right there. Could be... Excuse me. Could be down here, though. I don't mind it. Drop some money, please. Yes. The keys are going to be out of control. Well, no, there's going to be one key. Very much in control. Did I leave a penny back there? No, I did not. All right, well, it's time to go. It's been a slow Azazel run. But that was me doing my due diligence to give myself a good chance of getting Cuba meat. It didn't happen. Shit. That happens. Oh, I can't go back and get those keys. No! Let's go. So we're not going to use our Pandora's box. It actually is sometimes better, oftentimes better in that fact, or in the, for the matter, to use it on the womb. On womb one, I think you get two boss items, and on womb two, I think you get one boss item. I know that sounds backwards, but I think it's true. But on the cathedral, you get one angel item. So it's a bit of a risk-reward thing, you know. The angel items could be amazing, or they could be holy water. But the boss items could be amazing, you know, they could be magic mushroom, or they could be, you know, pageant boy or something like that. So it does cut both ways. I'd rather have a chance of getting a really amazing angel item, especially when we're on a run that's already, like, pretty dang good. I would suggest, at least. We're not out of the woods yet here by any stretch of the imagination. I would classify this as a 1 to winning run. It's a category 4 run. The only thing that would make a category 5 guaranteed one run, you know, barricade your windows, get ready, there's a storm coming, is Brimstone Mom's Knife, something along those lines. But still, a great run. I can't argue with that at all. Pandora's Box could turn into a category 5. I don't have real categories here. I should, though, now that I think about it, just because it would be ridiculous. Oh my god. Okay, the damage I'm taking is just god-awful. Let's stop doing that, or at least get some... Every time, man. At least get some balls of steel pills on the ground that I can take advantage of. Or some tinted rocks, for that matter. Oh, there is an exit up here. Yeah, I don't mind it. I actually made a mistake in taking Fate. We got HP from it, but we don't... What do we care about HP? One HP is meaningless. No? Okay. It would have been better off for us to have permanent Polaroid invincibility, especially if we had picked up Poison Touch there, or the virus, as it's actually known in reality. We didn't pick it up, so it's not that big of a deal. Whoa. When the AI on these guys, like... goes so quickly. Just makes me mad, man. There we go. How do like they fire and then vacate so quickly? It's absolute horse hockey. Taking a quick look for tinted rocks. I don't see any. If those were red chests, I would be all over it. I like that. I do not like that. I ended up taking my own damage there. Because I'm kind of an idiot sometimes. This is good, though. If you ever shoot a bullet at me in that situation again, I'm going to kick your ass so hard they can build a pool in the footprint. Alright. Easy, easy kills. Which is good, because I'm playing like an asshole right now. That was not our secret room, unfortunately. I should have used pheromones in that room. Yeah. In my defense... I never use pheromones properly, so expecting me to do it then is kind of the definition of insanity. I don't know if that is a, Oh, rosary bead might be better than flat penny for us at this point. I didn't know if that was a tinted rock, because it's hard to make out whether or not it is a tinted rock. Because of the map kind of obscuring it. So I figured we'd just spend one of our 78 bombs to check. Easy room. No doors over here. We've got to be coming close to the exit. You know what? I didn't think about it, but it's really going to burn me up if we end up fighting against death here and getting a third level cube of meat. I mean, it would be nice. It would be extremely unlikely. If you had asked me when I started this run, you know, without a Book of Revelations, how many cubes of meat would I expect to get? I would have said 0, not 3. But still... Okay, it's Mr. Fred. So Mr. Fred probably would have ruined our run anyway. He can still spawn with Book of Revelations, which makes no fucking sense to me. Conquest kind of makes sense. Why stand right there? We do have the Celtic Cross effect for some extra damage here. But Mr. Fred makes no sense to me as a boss who can spawn from Book of Revelations. Oh, Magic Mushroom. Alright, so we were going to get HP regardless. This is really good. I don't really care what we get here. Lump of coal would be better. So of course we get Krampus's head. Now we can take two boss items and Krampus's head, but I'm committed to the idea of the deal with the angel on this one. You know what's messed up is that I feel the need to apologize for this, Wow, look at how different our damage is on this floor compared to the last floor. I know I was having a conversation there and I kind of phased in and out of it. Ooh, this is awesome, actually. But yeah, I feel the need to apologize for this being a slow Azazel run, which is bullshit, you know? We're just doing what we need to do to survive and to try to get real Platinum God as well. We don't have a Guppy's Tail, so I don't really care about spending keys here. I'm kind of going to go back and forth here. See if we can get some important payouts. Two of clubs? Yeah, why not, you know? Two of spades would be much better, but can't always get what you want. We could get Master of Unlocking here, which I guess is, you know, the main reason you would want to play. I'm waiting for, like, permanent Polaroid invincibility. Or not Polaroid, but Celtic Cross invincibility to go through there. Oh, this is perfect. Okay. So we'll play the crap out of you, since we can. Pay close attention just to make sure your red hearts aren't disappearing. Missing page two. It gives us a black heart, at least. It's okay. It's not the best payout in the world from a Demon Judgment, but it's alright. Okay. The money is not really... I didn't donate. As soon as, like, I was like, wow, I have too much money. Why is that? Oh, right, I'm an idiot. It's alright, you push the bomb out of the way. Again, I don't really care about donation machine meta, to be honest with you. We're probably not going to need 20 keys, let's be honest. Let's give some back here. Well, more keys. More red hearts as well, which I appreciate, because we can actually maybe get a blood bag out of this. The money is pretty much worthless, but the blood bag... Oh, that was dumb. I didn't realize our invincibility wore off. Well, we got it back! As soon as you start blinking, stop playing. Oh, this is a Celtic Cross invincibility, so... Got a lot of plays out of this one. That's IV bag. Oh, that still hurt! Even though I was still in my Celtic Cross invincibility. Okay, you know what? We can't be trusted with that. I think we've proven that right there. We got another HP upgrade here. If we're gonna get HP, we might as well get a lot of it. What do you got for us, key beggar? Gave us three spiders. It's okay. I mean, I'm content to get down to four keys, honestly. As soon as we start blinking, we stop playing. Again, I can't be trusted. Oh, we don't stop freaking blinking. We just run out. That's what's confusing me there. Yeah, that's relatively strange. Maybe we should have stuck with Flat Penny. Could have played this like ad infinitum. We did just get Guppy's tail, though. Or Guppy's paw. We could get three Guppy items here. It's unlikely. I figured we'd play it all the way. And that'll be our fourth key, so... Hey, Infamy. Infamy's pretty good. Yeah, we played it all the way. We could become Guppy there. It's unlikely, though. But I like the permanent Polaroid invincibility. I think that is going to be valuable for us with a cube of meat. And Infamy's pretty good. We still have the hope of getting something great from Pandora's box on the next floor. We're going to win. Unless I royally fuck it up. That's like, I say that not to like be cocky. It's actually quite the opposite. The reason I call something a one run is so that if I lose, you know it's exactly my fault and not the game's fault. See, I'm just trying to be selfless. No tinted rocks. Red heart's not worth very much. Yeah, I guess we'll do it. Oh man, a black market this late in the game, or you know what I mean. It's not, they're not all black markets. Some of them are just free items, but or free trinkets, but I always like it when they show up. This one's just going to be a free item. Ah, it's broken remote. No thank you. That would teleport us as soon as we played Pandora's box, which is terrible. So this would reroll everything. I'm not going to do it. Not gonna do- I know what you're thinking. Could give you a cube of meat. I don't think it can. I think cube of meat only counts as one item in the item pool, so I think we'd actually go from, like, no cubes of meat to... Or we'd go from two cubes of meat to no cubes of meat. Could it give us D100? Yes. Yes, it could. I'll admit that, but, you know, I'm a little attached to this run. We've put in a lot of work to get to the point we're at here. I really don't want to lose Pandora's box after holding it for so long. And what we could do is use it so that, you know, we wouldn't technically lose it, but then we would not get the items that we picked up from it anyway. I will do more of those in the future, I promise. But for now, like this, it's mostly used for lost runs, like runs that are cursed. See, that's why I did it right there. Sacred Heart, baby! It did give us HP. Our damage is going to be absurd now. Thank you, Pandora's Box. Very glad that I did not reroll that now, and I think most people would agree. Now that we've got HP, it makes sense to get that Eternal Heart, I think. Why not, you know? Could teleport to a deal with the devil or something. We're going to be one-shotting almost everything now. If it wasn't a one-run before, it is very much a one-run now. Even Chubb, man. Chubb doesn't have a ton of HP, but I'm a little surprised at the amount of damage we were doing to him. Yeah, this is a one-run, without any doubt. Even if I fuck it up, there's no way that this shouldn't be a one-run at this point. Yeah, I'll play you. I don't know, maybe there's a chance you pay out with 2 cubes of meat? Like, I don't know, you pay out with a golden chest and a cube of meat. I open them up, they're both cubes of meat. Or you pay out with like a Perthrow rune and I reroll them. Let's be honest, it's not likely. Or even mathematically possible, but... The map, that's actually alright. Whoa, alright, well, we're almost certainly gonna have to go through this room, so... Let's do so. Considering we're probably gonna, like, two-shot the late-game bosses, I figured why not use Lemon Party on a room where maybe I can hit multiple enemies and save myself just the slightest bit of time. Oh, this is nice. You know what we need now? The obvious answer. Say it with me. 3, 2, 1. Tammy's head. Tammy's head. Yes, we need Tammy's head. It would be fantastic to get Tammy's head here. Very low range, but it would also one-shot any enemy that had the audacity to get within like a 5-tile radius of us. I'm not going back to pick up that dime. Or that penny right there. I don't care if it bothers you. If we get money equals power, we're already going to get a huge damage bonus from it. You know, don't be greedy. Having damage ain't everything. Not having it is. The problem with the Isaac fight as Azazel is that you got to get right up in his grill. Absolutely awful damage on my part. Should not have been anywhere near the riffraff that was happening there. If I'd actually managed to charge that shot, he would be dead. He's still dead. Just took us a slight bit longer. Alright, let's finish off this run. This is the longest Azazel run I've had in weeks, but it was a very close call when it came to actually getting that cube of meat, so I appreciate it. Sad Onion, Little Haunt, Lemon Mishap, and Butt Bombs. I don't know if Sad Onion is a damage modifier downwards. I wonder if we can almost, like, tap shoot. No. Still a pretty long charge time. Probably far right is where I'm going to have to guess that our boss action is going to be. Look, Lemon Mishap was not what I was looking for at all. But it's what we got. So we're going to have to live with it. Hopefully we get some golden chests in the process. We did get we got no shortage of luck upgrades. Is that really how big Lemon Mishap is right now? Do you see that? It's like the size of like 1/20th of the room. I thought it was bigger than that, but I guess I've been using Lemon Party a lot. So my metrics might be all messed up. We're hoping for a lot of golden chests to drop, or a lot of regular chests for that matter. Tammy's head is still, you know, something I dream about. It's always the one that gets away. You know what? Yeah. Just handle it that way. Keys, I mean, they might come in handy. Very funny game. Give me some Horsemen of the Apocalypse after screwing me out of my opportunity to get the 4th level Meat Boy. Much appreciated. One-shotting the bloat feels real nice. Real nice. Should get a Spirit Heart there, and I can actually use it, I think. With Curse of the Unknown, it's a little hard to tell. What are you going to be? What are you going to be? Bob's Curse. Eh. Eh. At least we got one item for free. Well, there you go, game. You got me. You got me good. Let's go fight Blue Baby, shall we? And Lemon Mishap, Little Haunt, they're going to do non-negligible amounts of damage. But this is really the Brimstone's time to shine. All right, a good run, a very close call. I hope you enjoyed the run. If you did, click the like button. It helps out a great deal. And of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.